Warren, and I'm a former Carroll County school teacher and now the parent of a kindergartner at Sandy Mount. I'm here because I am afraid for the future of our school system and for our county as a whole. We moved here from Baltimore County for this school system, and I feel as though I'm watching the system, which I once had so much faith in, completely fall apart. We fully understand that the system is in dire straits. We also understand that something drastic needs to be done to even begin to remedy the situation. I haven't heard one person here in any of this say that no action needs to be taken. All we're asking for is that the right action be taken. The bottom line in all of this is that we need to pay our teachers and show them that we value them as the foundation of a school system that we also value. From the beginning, this process has been flawed. In 2012, Superintendent Guthrie said that the VAC were not school closure experts and decided to hire MGT to do an outside study and get better options. That $88,000 study was then thrown out, and the responsibility was given back to the VAC. I understand that they're doing their best, but if they were not qualified enough to make their recommendations single-handedly in 2012, why are they now? The VAC was given no specific guidelines with which to make their recommendations. Without guidelines, they came up with their own, but that has led to inconsistency in those recommendations. There are schools on these lists that are underutilized, some that are in need of major capital improvement, and still others that are simply easy to redistrict. I'm certain that with better guidelines, a more consistent and cost-effective plan could be created. It was said that there would be community involvement in the process, but there was absolutely none until after the first set of options was presented. Why were there not members of the community working with the VAC? Perhaps a realtor who could have provided information on the potential impact to property values and taxes would have been helpful. Or at the very least, some other community stakeholders to provide other points of view. Given that a recommendation has now been made, I hope that the flaws in the process will be recognized and remedied as you move forward and consider future action. Right now, it feels as though your minds are made up about future action. Saying that no one is going to be redistricted twice leaves very few options for future school closures. I hope that this is not the case. I hope that you will look at this information with fresh eyes and adjust your boundary adjustment committee. Make the best decisions for the entire county. If you plan to stick with the original five, be honest and let us know that. Let us prepare for that. Obviously, emotions are running high because all of this is going to impact the lives of our kids and the future of the county as a whole. If this is done poorly, I really feel like we're going to watch the entire county and its economy fall to pieces. But there are solutions that can fix these issues without killing Carroll County.
Thank you.
Karen Alexander.